Hello and welcome everyone. Today we will introduce you to eazyBI reports and charts for Jira. This is the first episode of the series on how to create eazyBI reports. During the video, you will get to know eazyBI and have a quick overview of its basic concepts. eazyBI is a powerful analytics and reporting app for Jira. With eazyBI, you can build custom reports, charts, and dashboards from your Jira issues with just a few clicks. Jira contains several built-in reports and filtering options, so you may be asking, how is eazyBI different? As the name indicates, eazyBI is a business intelligence or BI tool. Using eazyBI's drag-and-drop report builder, you can explore, gather, and compare data in new ways, and extract the information you need to quickly answer specific questions. For example, while Jira reports and JQL queries are helpful for gathering Jira issue data, they don't always solve the tricky questions like totals, averages, and other custom calculations. In this video, we will take a quick overview of the three main steps that enable teams to begin benefiting from the many business intelligence capabilities of eazyBI. Importing data, create reports, and finally, publish them. Let's look into each of these steps in more detail. eazyBI is a non-real-time analysis tool, which means the data you want to analyze must first be imported from a source system like Jira. In addition, eazyBI can accept data from Jira apps, SQL databases, REST API, and other data sources. Use them separately or combine them with the Jira issue information. Data import ensures that Jira issues information is organized in a more report-friendly structure. Imported data are organized into the building blocks of eazyBI reports, called measures and dimensions. Let's take a closer look at the measures and dimensions. All numerical values in Jira are imported as measures, and can be things like original estimate values or created or resolved issue counts. As you may know, Jira issues have fields that contain data like issue type, assignee, resolution, and so on. These data and the Jira issues themselves are imported into eazyBI as dimensions. While dimensions identify the information being analyzed, measures show the quantitative value of it. Being able to separately pull dimensions and measures, eazyBI allows you to analyze data that within Jira may not be related. This means you can answer questions such as how many hours have been logged for all stories within the last month. Once the initial data import is completed, automatic updates between eazyBI and Jira can be scheduled, for example, once a day or even every hour. Manual data updates are always available too. Once the data are imported, they are ready to be used in report creation. In the eazyBI drag-and-drop report builder, all imported dimensions and measures appear automatically. They can be added, removed, and combined in the report builder to quickly build custom Jira reports or simply explore the data. At first, you will likely use only the predefined measures. As you get more comfortable with eazyBI, you can start creating your own custom calculations using the powerful MDX editor, with syntax highlighting and autocomplete. Once you select all the measures and dimensions for the report, you then choose how to represent data. Put them into a pivot table, a bar, or a pie chart, or a combination of columns, ranges, and lines. The last but not least phase is publishing reports, which makes it possible to share them with your team and stakeholders. There are several ways to do that. For instance, you could combine reports created in eazyBI into a dashboard that tells a story about a project's progress in a glance, which is perfect for sharing on a large screen in the office. Alternatively, use the eazyBI for Confluence app to share reports on a project's page. In this video, we covered the basics of getting started. What is eazyBI? What are the main process steps? As well as the most important terms in eazyBI, measures and dimensions. In the next episode, we will learn about eazyBI accounts and how to import Jira data into them. By the way, it's me, Robert. Meet you in the next video.